Woodridge fam, welcome to Food for Thought. Before we get started, just a quick reminder that the Black History Month Committee launched the Black History Month Recipe Share last week. So if you have a special family recipe that you're willing to share, please, please share that knowledge with the Woodridge family. All you have to do is send that recipe to woodridge.recipes@gmail.com and all the recipes will get shared via Class Dojo throughout the month. All right, today for Food for Thought, I won't be answering a scholar's question because I want to instead talk about important Black farmers from then and now. So Black farmers only make up about 1.34% of all farm producers. That's such a tiny percentage. All farmers are extremely important because they grow the food that nourishes us all, but Black farmers are significantly underappreciated. So today we're going to talk about some important Black people who have shaped the history of agriculture for us. The first is George Washington Carver. I'm sure many of you have already learned about George Washington Carver because he seems to be one of the most well-known Black agriculturalists, and kind of rightfully so. So George Washington Carver was an inventor and scientist who made hundreds of things out of mostly two things, sweet potatoes and peanuts. I didn't know you could turn peanuts into hundreds of things, but this guy sure did. George Washington Carver turned peanuts into things like plastics, paint, and soap. And he turned sweet potatoes into things like flour, vinegar, and rubber? Like, what? This guy was a total boss. And he also taught other Black farmers how to focus on making their soil healthy so that they could grow more food to sell. Another important Black figure in the history of agriculture is Frederick McKinley Jones. He created something super helpful in the food world, which was the refrigerated truck. That's a truck with cooling in the back. So nowadays, fruits, vegetables, and all types of food are sent all around the world, and if we didn't have refrigeration to keep these foods cold, they would all go bad before we got to buy and eat them. Frederick McKinley Jones invented the refrigerated truck, which made it possible for farmers to keep their food cold when they traveled to sell it, which allowed farmers to then make more money, because they then had good food to sell still. So those are two important Black figures, and there are countless others, who made some cool inventions that still help farmers to this day. And many are still continuing to do so today. So one person, for example, is Gail Taylor. Gail Taylor isn't necessarily an inventor like the previous two, but she is the owner of Three Part Harmony Farm right here in DC. It might be hard to imagine growing food in the middle of a city like DC, but Gail Taylor is doing it and she's killing it. Not only is she helping to ensure people in the city have access to fresh produce, but she's also dismantling racism in our food system by bringing pride back to farming while Black. Karen Washington is another prominent Black farmer who farms at Rise Up and Roots Deep Farm in New York. She's helped turn abandoned lots into urban farms to bring food to low-income communities in her city. Yes, that means she has turned concrete parking lots into beautiful green spaces that grow fresh produce for people in her community. I mean, how cool is that? She also has been working to use the word food apartheid over the word food desert, and in doing so, she brings attention to the systemically racist food system that we have here in the United States. It's important to recognize people like Carver, Jones, Taylor, and Washington because Black farmers have always been underappreciated and underrecognized. In the story of agriculture, white people are always the main characters, but to tell the whole story, we need to remember and celebrate the Black farmers and inventors who have also made farming what it is today. So everyone, say a thank you to all farmers for growing your food, but say a special thank you to people like Gail Taylor, Karen Washington, and all the Black farmers from then and now. All right, that's it for Food for Thought. Next week, I will pick up with answering scholars' questions. I'll see you all then. Bye.